Good morning, dear students. So today we are going to see the next video for chapter number 3.4 of unit 3, Shushruta, on page number 65. We are going to see part 2. So before starting this lesson, I would like to give you what is there in this part 2. Now, as we had seen in part 1 about Shushruta, now in this part, it acquaints us with veterinary therapy which developed early in India and how it was used by great king like Chandragupta Maurya and Emperor Ashoka to treat their animals, accompanying their armies and cattle as well. Animal byproducts were used by our ancestors. Indian needs to be made more aware of veterinary science as a career which is need of the hour. So let us begin with part 2. A tradition of veterinary therapy developed very early in India, and this has survived to the present time. Now the veterinary therapy, it was developed early time in India and still it is present. Okay, based on Ayurveda, Indian veterinary medicine is known for its specialized literature which provides information on ancient method of preventing and treating disease of animals. Some of these treatments little known outside India are still practiced today. Now, Indian veterinary medicine is known for its specialized literature. Indian veterinary medicines are specialized for their literature, okay, which provides information on ancient methods of preventing and treating a disease of animal. And in that literature, we can get the information about the ancient methods, how they were preventing and treating the disease of animals. Okay, some of this treatment literally known outside India, and some of this treatment which were written in that literature, they are little bit outside also, outside of India, and they are still practicing today. Okay, so let us start with the second stanza. The oldest existing veterinary text from India is a treatise entitled Ashva Ayurveda Siddhanta. Now, the oldest existing veterinary text, now the oldest text of veterinary from India is a treatise entitled. Now, the name of that book is what? Ashva Ayurveda Siddhanta. Okay, complete Ayurvedic system for horses, and in that only the disease prevention, cures, medicine, everything is written for only for what? For whom? Horses. Okay, attributed to Shailotra, and that book is attributed to whom? Shailotra. Shailotra has written that book around 2350 BCE. The founder of veterinary medicine, and we had seen in the introduction only that Shailotra was the founder, father and founder of the medicine, veterinary medicine. Subsequently, various treatises on horses and disease of horses are composed. Now, after that, many of the treatises on horses and disease were composed. Okay, Nakula, one of the five Pandavas, was a horse specialized himself. Now, one of the brother of Pandava named as Nakula, he was what? He was specialized in the horse, treating the horse. Okay, among the best known works of animal literature is Ashva Chikitsa, and the best among the animal, the best literature is known as what? Ashva Chikitsa, Therapeutics of Horses, written by Nakula, and this has been written by Nakula. Okay, Shushruta, a disciple of Shailotra, wrote an wrote on animal surgery. Now, the Shushruta, he was a disciple of Shalhotra and he has wrote on animal surgery. This made people aware of surgical method, dressing of wounds, bandaging of fractures, etc. Now, when he wrote this book on animal surgery, because of that book, many people were aware of what surgical method. Surgical means to have surgery, operation in short. Okay, so because of that book, the people came to know how to dress the wound, how to bandage the fractures. Okay, later, during the regime of Chandragupta Maurya, around 300 BC, veterinaries started accompanying armies to treat horses, elephants, as well as cattle. Now, later, during the regime of Chandragupta Maurya, when he was the emperor, Chandragupta Maurya, in that period, that is around 300 BC, veterinaries started accompanying armies. At that time, the veterinaries, the person who treat the animals, they started accompanying the armies also, because at that time the wars were going. So at that time they used to go with the armies, and they started to treat whom? The horses who were wounded, the elephants who were wounded in the battle. They started treating them as well as cattle also. Okay, the great emperor Ashoka erected the first known veterinary hospital. Come to page number 66 of the world. Now, the great king, the great emperor Ashoka, he also erected what? The first known veterinary hospital. He had started the first known hospital of the world. He arranged cultivation of herbal medicines for man and animals in his empire and adjoining kingdom. He had arranged the cultivation of herbal, the medicine which were used for the betterment of animals. He started to cultivate that medicines even for man also in his empire and adjoining kingdom. He started that cultivation near his kingdom only. Giving the animals general tonics and stimulants were practiced in order to ensure good mental and physical health. Giving the animal general tonics. He started to cultivate that herbs. At that time, he started to create tonics and stimulants. Stimulants means something that promotes activity. Okay, so was practiced in order to ensure good mental and physical health. And why it was produced? To ensure that the people or animals should have good mental and physical health. Okay, prevention of the occurrence of disease was also given importance. At that time, the occurrence of disease, what are the prevention for that? So at that time, the importance was given to that thing also. Cleanliness of animals, maintenance of stalls and stables, quality of food, disadvantages of overfeeding were looked after. Now at that time, they had seen many of the things, that is cleanliness of animal, whether the animals are cleaned or not, maintenance of stalls and stables, where the animals were living at that time, they used to keep on maintaining the stalls and tables, quality of food, what was given to the animals, disadvantages of overfeeding, what were the disadvantages of overfeeding the animals, that was also looked after. Utilization of animal byproducts was also done wisely by our ancestors. Now at that time, our ancestor used to take care of all things, the byproduct. That also they were doing wisely. Okay, conversion of milk into butter, ghee, curd, khoa, etc. Now the farm animals. Okay, when cow used to give the buffalo and cow used to give the milk, at that time they used to make ghee also, butter also, buttermilk also, curd, khoa, etc. So these are what byproducts. Was common practice and still is, and it was practiced from first and still it is practicing. Okay, chicken was utilized for its meat while sheep was utilized for its wool. So chicken was utilized as a meat and sheep while sheep was utilized for the wool. Although India has always had immense knowledge in the field of veterinary science. So from ancient time only we had an immense knowledge. Immense means huge, okay? Bahut sara knowledge in the field of veterinary science. It is not chosen as a career by many due to lack of awareness, and because of this it is not chosen. Veterinary vet, doctor vet, has not been chosen as a career. Why? Because we don't have awareness. Being an agriculture based country, our country is agriculture based. Today India needs more veterinaries who emphasize with animal and give their 100% to the profession. Now what it is said, as India is an agriculture country, India needs more veterinary. So here the author is telling that India need what? More veterinaries who empathized. Empathize means what? To feel or understand another's person feeling and pain, okay, with animals. To feel the pain of the animals and give their 100% to the profession. And the person who is going to become a veterinary, he should give their 100% to this profession. The writer, the author for this chapter is Dr. Chiratana Matkari. Okay, I hope you all have understood this lesson, and you have to complete the PDF of question answers which I had given in neat handwriting. Thank you. Have a nice day.